Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. In this video, I'm going to show you how to find the good sounds in FL Studio. So I want you guys to understand that the stock sounds in FL Studio are getting better, but they're not going to sound like my Korg Kronos. It's just not. It's not going to. Now, if you guys go to the browser and then go to where it says sounds, here you can find the FL Cloud if you guys want to upgrade your sounds. Now, this is at a cost. It's not free. Look for the FL Studio Cloud plugins, okay? So look for the company UVI and look for the company called Minimal Audio. Their current plugin's really good. Their effects plugins are good. And look for UVI. Anything from UVI is fire, okay? So the thing is, those are paid. So as far as stock plugins, though, if you guys are making like new jazz or some of these like modern yeet type beats, here are some plugins you guys can mess with. So GMS is a really good one for leads and basses. Now, I'm just going to play random stuff. This is not me making a beat right now. Okay, but very synth-based stuff. It has some West Coast sounds in here, but mainly it's good with its leads. Okay, so what most people don't know, though, is in this plugin, if you click the drop down, you can actually load a waveform in GMS. So you guys can download waveforms off the internet from various synths and different things, and you could load them up right inside of GMS. A lot of people overlook that feature. Okay, so it does the basics pretty easily on that plugin. Another plugin for the new jazz sound is called Morphine. This one's really good for West Coast as well. If you go to the keyboards and look up, where is it at here? Any kind of EP piano. Again, I'm just playing random stuff, guys. It's not a beat making video. Okay, so we're gonna play that, or let me see here. It's a preset in here. Here, this one's really good. Crystal EP. All right, so super good on that one. And also try out their vocal preset called Vowels for that West Coast sound. That's a really good one. And they have some string presets in here that are pretty good, like the violin. So pretty good stuff in Morphine. Nobody really talks about this, but that's a West Coast / Yeet style plugin. Another plugin here is Sawer. Now, I overlooked this for years because I was not understanding. Okay, so in short, though, you can go to leads. I like this first lead patch and play it at low octaves. It's going to give you that Benny X style bass. So really good for West Coast. Now also, two people don't know, if you click on this image line icon, it actually reveals the effects. So there's a lot about SAR that people kind of overlook, but it can do a lot. Those are pretty much the go-tos. Nextly is Toxic Biohazard, slept on plugin, like super slept on. This is good for more like Playboi Carti sounds and like more the yeet type synthetic sounds. If you guys go to keyboards and kind of just really any patch in here, this is an easier citrus. Basically, citrus is really complicated. It's not for beginners at all. It's not even really for, like, as an advanced sound designer, it's hard to use citrus just from its interface. But I'll show you guys a secret about citrus you probably didn't know. So this is good for Playboi Carti sounds, again, yeet sounds, any kind of modern synthetic based sound you can get probably in Toxic Biohazard. There's one more honorable mention plugin that comes with FL called Poizone. Where is it at? Poizone. Here we go. Poizone. Now, this is good, but how do I explain this plugin? I used to use a lot of presets, but you can build your own sounds in here. You just kind of have to know what you're doing. Put it that way. But it's a little bit simplified, but it can achieve really cool sounds. So again, I'm not sitting here with sound demos, but it has some pretty dope sounds in there. Now, what else is there? There is Citrus, which most people kind of swear by. For me, I'm being honest with y'all. I've trained over a million producers around the world, so I'm going to work with Drake, Kanye West, Post Malone, Ariana Grande, French Montana, Young Thug, Lil Baby, Polo G, Trippie Redd, J. Cole, Kendrick Lamar, and a long list. And I could tell you that teaching these folks, if I were to start with this and this was like the starting point for a beginner, they would be so confused about music, it wouldn't even be funny. This is a very, 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 very advanced and complicated tool. You could literally spend 30 minutes trying to get a patch to sound good enough. So that's why I don't recommend this, unless you guys are like sound designers. It's just not something I would recommend. because making small changes is complicated unless you know what you're doing. So in here, what most people don't know is if you go to the drop down in the top right, go to Yamaha DX7, it says import system expansion. So if you go to Google, for example, you can actually look up Yamaha system expansions and it will pull up a website where you guys can download those and import those straight into Citrus like that. Okay, so that's something that most people don't know about. The next plugin here, now, if you're moving into the EDM side, there's Harm More is really good. I don't use it as much anymore. It, you know, it's good. What most people don't know about this, though, is if you click this little eyeball, it shows you the harmonics on the right side. So it has a baked-in spectrum, which is really good for learning sound design and, like, the concept of frequency and what stuff is. Like, what is a phaser doing? It's basically cutting out frequencies so you can see it visually. This little black line means it's cutting and removing frequency. So it teaches you stuff like that with sound design. I don't use it, though. The last time I opened that was so long ago. Now, the new plugin that people are starting to embrace is called Flex. This is good enough. But again, does it sound like a Korg Kronos? No. Like, I don't want you guys chasing wind, because here's what happens as a beginner. You guys will be like, okay, these are the best FL plugins. Now I'm going to sound like Metro. Now I'm going to sound like, you know, these top producers. And yeah, Metro might use Flex in a couple beats, but like their sound quality is up here. Flex is like down here still. And there's room to improve. I'm not trying to criticize the plugin. I'm saying that when you compare it to the real sound of a keyboard, the sound of the keyboard's way up here. And then you guys are using sounds down here and you're trying to use plugins to try to like match the sound quality. It's never going to happen because it's sample based and the samples aren't good to begin with the way it was sampled. So just understand that, like, I don't want you guys wasting time trying to make stock sounds sound like professional sounds. It's not going to. So just accept that these are not the greatest sounds in the world. They're good enough, but they're not the greatest sounds in the world. Now, if you guys are really like trying to like get the greatest sounds in the world, maybe Logic Pro is better for you, because Logic Pro's stock sounds are incredible. Their stock synths sound super just high fidelity, especially if you're on Mac. So that's what I would recommend as far as sounds. But as far as workflow, FL Studio is the greatest canvas, in my opinion, in the workflow. So that's why we use FL. But when you get FL, you might think that it comes with everything, and that's like not how it works. Like you get FL, it's a great canvas, and then you gotta find drum kits, which is 99% of the sound. Go to Reddit, find some drum kits, go to our Discord, whatever. And then you wanna grab the plugins that you guys like, and then you combine all that stuff onto the canvas. So you will have to spend a little bit more money here and there to fully get everything you're trying to get out of FL Studio. It's not like everything you need right under the hood type thing. Okay, and lastly, as far as FL, I guess the last plugin, if you're making Afro, I would look into, I think it's the Fruity DX10. There's a preset here called Log Drum. Benny X uses this sound in some of his remixes. I don't know what plugin he uses specifically, but so that's that kind of Afro influenced sound that they use, almost like their version of the Spins 808. They use Log Drum. Shout out to X Dizzle for showing me that. And that's pretty much it as far as like go-to plugins that I would actually use in FL Studio. One last thing, one honorable mention. Now for hip hop, if you guys are doing like Memphis stuff, go to FL Keys, go to Presets, and then go to Dance Piano and play really low octaves. To do this, right click up here on your typing keyboard and choose a low octave like 3 or 2. So that's where they get that piano sound from. FL Keys. That's the only time I use FL Keys, is for that specific sound in hip hop. Again, everything else is kind of up to you guys' style. Oh, one last thing, I keep forgetting about this because I don't use it personally, but people swear by it. It is called Sakura. Sakura, where are you? Sakura, here we go. Okay, so Sakura. Again, I don't use it. I'm sure it has its benefits. I just don't use it. Like, we are in a low octave. Let me be fair here. My fault. I guess that's a pretty dope sound. Now that sounds pretty dope. I would use that for like Drake type stuff. I just never really found a use for it. That has some nice EP sounds. But I think most people use this for the strings, from what I remember. So I think it's a physical modeling plugin, if I'm not mistaken. I guess these sounds are pretty good now that I'm like hearing it by itself. But again, I don't reach for this plugin. So that's why I'm out of the loop. I guess they're good. I'd that changed my mind. For some reason today, Sakura sounds good. Usually I don't go for it though. Okay, so I think we covered all of the stuff that I actually use as far as how to find the good sounds. And just for the people using Funk or making Funk, go to your browser, go to PEX, go to Legacy, go to Drums, and then go to where it says Vintage. This is your TR-808 kit from Roland, which has the famous cowbell and then like, you know, basic kind of Roland sounds. Okay, so that's where you get those sounds from. That's pretty much as far as stock sounds, how to get the most out of the stock sounds. Now again, you guys could download for Citrus those Yamaha DX7 expansions. You guys can get those off the internet. You have to import those. You guys can open up in GMS. Remember, you can insert here if you click the drop down, go to load waveform. You can find waveforms on the internet. I would recommend if you're a beginner producer, just go to Reddit, type in artist drum kit Reddit, genre drum kit Reddit. So like if I'm looking for drill drum kit Reddit, yeet drum kit Reddit, who else, Kanye West drum kit Reddit, like, and you'll find 99% of what you guys are looking for as far as sound selection. The sound generating plugins, that's really up to what you guys are looking for. There aren't too many organic sounds inside of FL Studio stock stuff. That's where the honorable mention of FL Cloud comes into play. Look for the UVI stuff under FL Cloud. You can log in for free. I think it's a free trial, but it's a pay program. And basically look for the UVI stuff because they are just the best sound company I've ever heard. Their sound quality is impeccable. Okay, and then Minimal Audio has a really good plugin suite. So those are the ways to get the most out of FL if you don't know where to start. And I'm trying to really make sure I cover everything before I end this video. I think that is everything. So let me just skim really quickly and just make sure that I covered everything that I promised to cover today. So if you like me covering all these and you want something specific, let me know in the comments below. What do you guys have issues with FL? Like, where do you get stuck in FL? And I'll probably cover that if a lot of people like your comment. So leave that comment below. I think we covered everything. Yeah, that's pretty much it. All right, guys. Peace, subscribe, and like the video, share with a friend. Peace.